actually, I would say that it's not that people see the relationship with the boss like a marriage, binding like a marriage. I would say they see the relationship with the boss binding like the relationship with the first authority that they grew up with. You got to go back. Everybody brings an emotional dowry to work. Everybody has a relationship history. And sometimes I will stay with you, A, because I don't actually believe or know that it can be better. B, because something inside of me thinks that that's what I deserve. C, because I am there to prove that I can take it and that you won't break me. And I can be defiant to you. Four, you know, and now imagine that you're not talking to the employee, but you're talking to the child of the parents. And imagine how this child talked to the parents. I will never be crushed like my mother was crushed. I can take this. Or, you know, I don't even know what it's like for people to be kind to me, because that I don't trust kind people. I actually only trust people who are critical, because they tell you the truth. That's a freaking distortion, but it's not a rare one. Or I am responsible. Or I don't. For I take care of people, and I can't let go of this. Or I don't know that somebody else would want me. And I've already have managed here. I've learned to survive, and it's a familiar space. And I would prefer that than having to start the whole thing all over, because I don't necessarily think that I can travel from place to place and take that with me. I just think, you know, I got my bearings here. I know how to survive here, and surviving is the way I live, which comes back to the last question which you asked, which is not dead versus alive. Some people live on a level of surviving, and some people live on a level of thriving. Some relationships are not dead, and some relationships are alive. Some companies survive, some companies thrive. And everybody knows the difference between allocating all your resources just to survive, to make it, to keep your head above water, to know where the danger is, to manage it, versus feeling that you have the thing is stable, it's safe enough, so you can actually go, think, be creative, innovate, explore, like a child. The child that can leave your lap knows that the lap will be there when they come back. The child that doesn't feel safe will not leave your lap. It's in us from the start. And it just stays like that, but looks differently as we grow older or as the system becomes more complex.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
So that's why people stay in abusive relationships.
Yeah.
And that, but also in abusive relationship, you often have one more piece. And this may be also actually in the question that she asked, which is that, I can put you down. And then there is a moment where you may say, I'm about to leave. This is differently maybe than at work. Or I start to feel that you're investing less. And now I come after you. And your acceptance of me is my redemption. It's you're saying to me, you're not that bad after all. So the abusive cycle always has a redemptive moment. After, you know, in domestic violence, it's very clear. After I hit you, I feel so bad. How could I do this to you? You're the most important person to me. I'm so sorry. I feel ashamed. And then you're going to say, no, you're not that bad. You're just a wounded man who is acting like this, or a wounded woman who is acting like this. And that gives you suddenly the power to redeem me. And now we have a power shift, where the person at the bottom has the power from the bottom up, the way that the person at the top had the bottom at the power going down. And that corrective piece is what actually makes the thing go around and around and around. If it was just, at some point people would snap much sooner. The reason they don't snap sooner is because they get their turn. This is a different subject.
But it still relates.
It relates because the dynamic of harassment often implies my saying to you, you're so special, you're the best. You're so the best that I give you special attention. And that special attention, as we said, could be on the side of intrusion or neglect.
Okay.